Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a great question sent in by James. If you have a question for the podcast, please feel free to either call in and leave your question as a voicemail or drop me a note, bill@MrExcel.com. James said, hey, I have a workbook, has 20 different worksheets, and I need a way to take the data from all of those worksheets and combine them into a single worksheet. Well, you know, this is one that would be relatively hard to build with formulas because you never know how many rows you're going to have. And it's really easy to do with a macro. So we said we're going to try and do some VBA once a week. Today's the day I'm going to switch over to VBA. And it takes about 10 lines of code. What we're going to do is we're first going to add a brand new worksheet to this workbook. But we're not just going to use workbooks.add. We're going to set that new worksheet equal to an object variable. So set WSN. That's my abbreviation for worksheet new equal to worksheets.add. That's basically going to add a new worksheet and give us a little variable name, WSN, that'll allow us to reference that worksheet. I'm going to have a variable called next row. I'm going to set that equal to 1. That tells me where I'm about to copy. Now we're going to loop through each worksheet in the workbook. So we'll say for each WS, WS is just a variable in this workbook dot worksheets. First thing, if it's the sheet that we happen to be grabbing is WSN, we don't want to do anything. So we say if not WSN.name equals WS.name, then how many rows do we have today? How many rows are on WS? So we say final row equals WS.cells. Now we want to start at either 65536 in Excel 2003 and before, or 1048576 in Excel 2007. So I'm going to use rows.count, comma 1, press the N key, and then XL up dot row. That'll tell me how many rows I happen to have today, assuming that I have data in column A. Now we're going to copy those rows. So we'll do WS dot cells. Start in row 1, column 1, and we'll use a resize, dot resize. How many rows? Well, we'll use final row. How many columns? Well, we'd have to know how many columns we have. Let's say that we had 20 columns worth of data. Dot copy. We can just put where the destination is. The destination is WSN dot cells. Which row do we want to copy to? Well, it's that variable, next row, and which column? It's column number 1. Finally, we have to make sure that next row gets larger each time, so we'll say next row equals next row plus final row. That way, the second time through the loop, it'll write to the correct spot. Finally, we have to end that if block, end if, and then end the loop. And that basically does it. That does our whole loop. Now at the end, I just want to do a few things. I want to make sure that we activate that new worksheet, WSN.select, and maybe give them a quick little message box. We could say final or next row minus 1 ampersand, that's the concatenation character, rows combined. There you go. Simple little macro. If the comments weren't there, it'd be about 11 lines of text. We can go through and run that macro. So we'll hit Tools, Macro, and choose Combine All, click Run. Sure enough, 3,384 rows combined. Now, the one problem that we have here is the new sheet was not inserted at the beginning, and we also get our headings appearing throughout the worksheet. We probably should have added some code there that said, hey, is this the first time we're doing the copy? If so, start at row 1. Otherwise, start at row 2. But you get the basic idea. Very simple little macro that will solve this problem. Every time we run the macro, we get a brand new sheet that will copy all the other sheets, whether there's 3 sheets, 5 sheets, or 50 sheets, copy them into a single worksheet. Thanks to James for sending in that question, and thanks to you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.